In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Grant, Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed the Christ to them. With one accord, the crowds paid attention to what was said by Philip, when they heard it and saw the signs he was doing. For unclean spirits, crying out in a loud voice, came out of many possessed people, and many paralyzed or crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. Now when the apostles in Jerusalem heard that Samaria had accepted the word of God, they sent them Peter and John, went down and prayed for them, that they might receive the Holy Spirit, for it had not fallen upon any of them. They had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then they laid hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, sanctify Christ as Lord in your hearts. Always be ready to give an explanation to anyone who asks you for a reason for your hope, but do it with gentleness and reverence, keeping your conscience clear so that when you are maligned, those who defame your good conduct in Christ may themselves be put to shame. For it is better to suffer for doing good, if that be the will of God, than for doing evil. For Christ also suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might be redeemed to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
So much for the technical. Now back to the meaning. In his Last Supper narrative, and I said it was after five long chapters, Jesus promises to send his Spirit upon the disciples five times. And we're hearing one of them today. Philip, you recall, we heard about him in the first reading today for the Acts of the Apostles. He went down to the city of Samaria and he was preaching. It says that after Jesus died, Philip really was engaged in the work of being an apostle, being a preacher. And he is the one that says at one point in the Gospel of John, Jesus, Lord, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us. And Jesus' response is still, if you see me, you see the Father. Don't you understand that? And Philip didn't. He saw Jesus, but didn't realize that he was seeing God. And Jesus goes on, you know, tells us, I will send the Spirit to you. It will be my Spirit, the Spirit that makes me who I am. That's the Spirit I'm going to send you. And that Spirit will be in you, and therefore I will be in you. I will be in you. And when they look at you, you ordinary men and women, when they look at you, they will see me. And when they see me, they will see the Father. These words ought to be consoling, but they are also very, very challenging. The very thought that when people look upon me, my behavior, my attitude, my remarks, the way I treat them, they should see Jesus. And when they see Jesus, they see God. And the very same is true for you. The Spirit that Jesus promises to send is the Spirit that makes him who he is. Son of God, possessed by God. And when we look upon him, we see God. So when people look upon us, they should see him, and therefore see God.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and a life everlasting. Let us offer to our Heavenly Father our prayers of petition.
For all the baptized, that we proclaim Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of our towns and cities, that they pay attention to the Christian message this Easter and receive it with joy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For nurses and doctors, that they continue to serve and heal in freedom of conscience, let us pray, O Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For those who cannot accept the Spirit of truth, that their hearts be converted, let us pray, O Lord. For this Eucharistic gathering, that we love Christ and sanctify him as Lord in our hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for today's Mass intentions, the living deceased for Mother's Day Novena, for the reposed soul of Reverend Kazimir Polinsky, for the living deceased Antoinette, family and friends, reposed the soul of Leo J. Chudinsky Jr., for the reposed soul of Angeline Pogodsky, Henry Pogodsky, for the reposed soul of Moses and Josephine Paulin, for the reposed soul of Juanita Cruz, and for the health and blessings of Lord Roberto Torres, and for birthday blessings for Holy Marriage, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us pray for parishioners of St. Patrick, for health, for happiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning,
is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the grace of our refusal, for our good and our souls.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be confirmed in the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to love yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers of the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Thank you.
on you, the Holy Lord, the Fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, Bishop Thomas, our pastor, all the clergy and other ministers of the gospel. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her beloved spouse, Philip, Henry, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty heavenly God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Go forth and announce the gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God.